do anything and everything. So words by Swami Vivekananda. So children, we are seeing chapter 19, that is the struggle for independence, right? So in the last class we have seen about the rise of independence. So in today's class we are going to continue that same, and one more thing we are going to add in this video, that is the partition of Bengal and the Swadeshi movement. So we can enter into the class.
So however, several other leaders were not in favor of such a soft approach. They felt that they would gain nothing by following such approach. So there were preferred a stronger and more effective opposition to the British. So they wanted a Swaraj or self-rule for the Indians. So they were called the radicals. So these are the few points about the rise of Indian nationalism. So this is the picture of the Hind Swaraj, the Indian home rule. So it is nothing but the self-government or independence for India. So this is the meaning of Swaraj. So next we are going to see some of the important leaders of this group. So first comes Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So his year was 23 July 1856 to 1st August 1920. So next comes Bipin Chandra Pal. So his year was 7th November 1858 to 20th May 1932. And Lala Lajpat Rai. So his year was 28th January 1865 to 17th November 1928. So these are all some of the important leaders of this group. So there was a person named Tilak, right? So we had seen in the picture. So Tilak declared, "Freedom is my birthright and I shall have it." He started a newspaper called Kesari in which he spoke out against the British. He wanted to arouse the feeling of patriotism in Indians. So we had seen some of the few points about Tilak, right? Now we are going to watch a video on him.
The father of Indian national movement was born on 23rd July 1856. Often revered as a martyr and a national hero, Tilak's slogan during the freedom struggle, "Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it," inspired millions of Indians. Besides a great freedom fighter, Tilak was a committed social reformer, writer and a journalist. He firmly stood against the practice of early marriages. He started the tradition of Ganesh Utsav in Maharashtra to spread the message of Swaraj. Tilak began a mass movement towards independence that was camouflaged by an emphasis on a religious and cultural revival. During the freedom struggle, Lokmanya Tilak strongly criticized British administration through his newspapers Maratha and Kesari. Opposing the moderate attitude of Congress, Tilak and two other big leaders advocated nationalism, and these three were referred to as the Lal Bal Pal Triumvirate. Tilak was sent to Mandalay Jail, Burma from 1908 to 1914 for supporting Indian freedom fighters. After returning, he founded Home Rule League and reunited with his fellow nationalists. Bal Gangadhar Tilak died on 1st August 1920 in Bombay. As a tribute, Mahatma Gandhi termed him as the founder of the modern India. Bureau Report, DT News.
So now we had watched the video, right? Now we are going to see the partition of Bengal and the Swadeshi movement. So the British were worried about the growing feelings of nationalism among the Indians. So they realized that if the people of India got united, they could easily throw the British out. So when we are united, no one can touch us, right? So they also realized that if the people of India got united all together, so they could not easily throw the British out. So this is what the sentence was. One of the way in which they could prevent Indians from the united was to divide them on the basis of religion. So at that time, the feelings of nationalism was strongest in Bengal. So this is the picture which we are seeing is the partition of Bengal in the year 1905. So they decided to divide Bengal into two parts. So one is for Hindus and other for the Muslims. So in the picture itself, you could see the partition of Hindus and Muslims. So Indians protested strongest against the division of Bengal. So the anger in the people gave the rise to the Swadeshi movement. So this is the picture which we are seeing, Swadeshi movement in India. The year was 1905 to 1908. So Swadeshi means own country. People pledged to us to use goods made in their own country and boycotted the British goods. So we have to use our own materials which is made in our own country. So we should not use any goods which is produced by the British. So bonfires of British goods, especially like clothes, were made at several places. Women and students also participated in the movement. It started in Bengal but soon spread to other parts of India. So finally, the British tried to put down the movement. People were fined and beaten. But ultimately, the opposition to the partition of Bengal was successful and the British were forced to be with it. So this is what the topic which we had covered in this lesson. Now we can watch a small video on Swadeshi movement.
The Swadeshi movement. The late 19th century saw the East India Company forcing Indian farmers to grow cotton and indigo for export to Britain. What followed was the import of finished goods, mainly clothes, from Britain for sale in India. So, despite being a leading producer of cotton, the Indian markets faced a shortage in the availability of raw cotton, as most of it was exported to Britain. As a result, the clothes produced by Indians were more expensive than the ones imported from Britain, and the Indians began preferring to buy foreign goods. This vicious cycle of British trade spread poverty and suffering among the weavers and farmers of India. The misery of these poor masses prompted nationalists like Lokmanya Tilak, Aurobindo Ghosh, Lala Lajpat Rai and V.O. Chidambaram Pillai to initiate the Swadeshi movement in 1905. Swadeshi means belonging to one's own nation, and this Swadeshi movement was an economic strategy that appealed to the Indian masses to use only goods produced in India instead of those being imported from Britain. In 1921, when Mahatma Gandhi took over the leadership of the Indian National Congress, the unrelenting British were still continuing to exploit the Indian farmers and weavers. Mahatma Gandhi added momentum to the Swadeshi movement by emphasizing the need for Indians to wear only khadi, the hand-woven cloth, and boycott the mill-made clothes brought in from Britain. The Indian people not only bought and wore khadi, but also threw the mill-made clothes into bonfires set up on the roads to show their resentment to the British oppression. This resulted in the making of more khadi by weavers, the growth of village industries, and a substantial reduction in the export of cotton. What the Swadeshi movement did was that it propelled the Indians to think in terms of national self-sufficiency. It made the simple hand-spun cloth a medium through which the quality of life of millions of weavers in the villages of India could be uplifted. It gave life to Gandhiji's belief that the true India could be found not in its few cities, but in its 700,000 villages.
So children, in this class, we had learned about the rise of independence and after that the partition of Bengal, that is the partition between Hindus and Muslims. Then also we had seen about Swadeshi movement. Along with that, we had received two videos, right? One is about Balagangadhar Tilak and another one is about Swadeshi movement. So along with this video, you will be receiving your worksheet. So try to complete your worksheet and post it in your WhatsApp group. So we can meet in the next class, children.